ngiya ku special doctor e Platon Bupe. Then that has been positive. Zange ndibe right, ndazifile right. Ndathi ndivakala uba okay ndiphozile, ndathi ugqirha uyaxoka. Ndathi uyaxoka doctor, wathi serious is. Ndabuya ndimarit, ndabuya ndazapha iCape Town ndaxelela ihusband yam uba ne-HIV positive. Zange ndithethe, ndaye ndamnika ileta ndandinikwa ngudoctor. Umnika kwam loo leta wathi u-HIV positive. Waphuma ndathi kena ke waphuma wahamba.
With 5 million people estimated to be HIV positive, South Africa has the largest number of people living with HIV in the world. The township of Khayelitsha, just outside Cape Town, is one of the areas most affected by HIV, with 20% of its 500,000 adult residents living with the virus. In 2003, the government of South Africa launched a national HIV care and treatment program and has progressively scaled up HIV care services. By mid-2011, 1.8 million people had been initiated on antiretroviral treatment, about 55% of those considered eligible. In Khayelitsha, scale-up has been exponential. By August 2012, more than 24,000 people were receiving antiretroviral treatment from just 100 people a decade earlier. As the number of people on treatment increases, so does the proportion of people being lost to care as clinics become saturated. On a typical day, at 8 in the morning, the Ubuntu clinic in Khayelitsha is already packed to capacity. Patients can wait most of the day to be seen by a nurse or a doctor and receive their antiretroviral treatment. For Regina Fanele, getting her treatment is only a matter of minutes. She only needs to take a 10-minute walk through Khayelitsha's narrow alleys to Unica's house, where a community ART Adherence Club is being hosted. Here, a small group of HIV-positive people on ARV treatment meet for 45 minutes every 2 months to collect their medications. With the guidance of a lay facilitator, club members go through a quick clinical checkup, a peer discussion, and receive pre-packed ART. By 9 a.m., Regina is already on her way to Cape Town's city centre, where she works as a domestic worker in private residences and offices.
So, then it turns into a club in. We call it a club in. I will sell it. Ella, special needs. We sell it by clinic because the clinic we sell special needs and we sell it in a folder. We money folder. We go. We are one late. So.
The ART Adherence Club model was piloted by Médecins Sans Frontières, or MSF, in Khayelitsha in November 2007. The model is helping decongest primary healthcare facilities by managing stable ART patients in non-clinical settings. It also enables clinicians to spend more time with new ART patients and those who are unwell or at risk of failing their treatment.
The clinicians in the clinic, they recruit the stable ARV patients. And what do we mean by stable? We mean patients that have undetectable viral loads and always attend their appointments. So are likely to be very adherent patients. Clinicians ask them whether they want to join clubs. And if they do, recruit them to a club. We then put 30 of these stable adherent patients together in a club. And this club meets every 2 months. In Ubuntu Clinic, we now have 69 clubs with different types of clubs for patients with different types of needs. So we have our adult clubs that meet during the day, and we also now have evening clubs for patients that are working during the day and can't come. Those run in the evening. And we have family clubs where the caregiver or family member and child are in the same club. So they both get their treatment together. And the last type of club which we've introduced are community clubs, which are essentially moving the clubs into the community. Firstly, we moved them to a community venue close to the clinic. And more recently, in May this year, we're now starting to pilot them being fully decentralized into the community. So in patients' homes and community venues around the corner from the club member's home. The Western Cape Department of Health and City Health looked at the pilot in Ubuntu and the outcomes and decided it was a model that would work for rollout in the Western Cape. And together with support from MSF and another NGO called IHI, worked together on rolling them out in the Cape Metro from January 2011. In Khayelitsha now, we have 180 clubs across 9 facilities, which amounts to roughly 19% of the 23,000 patients retained in care in Khayelitsha alone. In the Cape Metro, the rollout has been extremely successful, with 410 clubs set up already, and the rollout going ahead at a quick pace.
Adherence to treatment is certainly improved when patients no longer have to waste a day every month to fetch their antiretroviral treatment, but can instead spend an hour every 2 months in the supportive, friendly environment of the clubs. Bringing clubs into patients' homes can help fight the stigma surrounding HIV in their communities.
We just come and sit and we talk. We talk about things that make us a community that we are, the community that lives with HIV. And I love that there's plenty of us that are coming together and sit and talk about other things too that matters the most to us, what to eat, how we can keep ourselves happy and healthy. It's really, I like the club. I just love it. It's good.
MSF's analysis of the ART Adherence Clubs initially hosted at Ubuntu found that retention and care was 97% in the clubs as opposed to 85% among patients who qualified for clubs but stayed in mainstream clinic care. In addition, patients in clubs are 67% less likely to develop virological rebound. This means that they are not only more likely to stay in care but are also more adherent to their treatment. The club's ability to fit around patients' busy lifestyles clearly plays a key role in the success of the club model. For patients like Bongiwe Vutuza, whose livelihood relies on her informal job as a clothes trader, losing a day's earning in order to get her antiretroviral treatment is not an option. Every 2 months, Bongiwe attends an ART adherence club at the local library in Khayelitsha. This facility now hosts 23 clubs that were previously hosted at Ubuntu Clinic. The club session starts at 8 in the morning and lasts just over an hour, which allows patients to quickly resume their daily tasks.
E club ina kungeni noba ngubani. Uthi uze ufakwe kwi club ube utya i treatment yakho right, awuphosi zi date, then da join ke club in kuba ikhadi lam li clean, ndisoloko ndizithatha regular ipilisi zam. Ndifune ujoyina i club kuba i club in zonke izinto zibalula, uyakhawulezelelwa, awufani naxa uze eklinikhi ubuhlala ufike ngo-7 eklinikhi in the morning uphinde uyogoduka ngo-4 emva kwedinara. Then eklabhini siyakhawuleziselwa itreatment yakufika seyireyithi and nabantu abasebenza ngathi abasinikayo iipilisi like osisintoshi nosisifanelwa ba-friendly, uyakwazi uthi noba uneproblem ukwazi uyithetha kubo, bayafikeleleka for thina. And nathi xa sinengxaki siyakwazi uyidiscasa apha egroupini.
The club session is facilitated by a lay counselor or peer supporter. Facilitators are responsible for ordering, receiving, and checking antiretroviral medication that has been pre-packed either at the clinic's pharmacy or through a central dispensing service. During the club session, facilitators are responsible for registering members, conducting peer support talks, screening patients' weights, checking for possible symptoms, and distributing two-month ARV supplies. At the end of each session, they return uncollected ART packs to the pharmacy and hand the club register to the data capturer based at the clinic. Facilitators are also responsible for following up with patients who missed the session. Patients reporting symptoms or weight loss are referred back to the clinic for assessment by a nurse. All club patients attend the clinic twice a year, once for blood taking and 2 months later for their annual clinical checkup.
Since the clubs are in place, the number of patients that we see are lesser than the amount of patients that we used to see before. Now we've got ample time, I must say, that we can look at one patient and have at least a listening ear to their personal problems. Although we don't have a social worker in our unit here at Ubuntu, we refer them, and we've got enough time for those that have a CD4 count of 350, then they can be able to be started on the medication straight away.
As South Africa strives to put 3 million people on antiretroviral treatment by 2015, its national health system faces the enormous challenge of initiating 1 million more people on ART while retaining those who are already on treatment. ART adherence clubs can help relieve the burden placed on clinics by this ever-increasing patient load. More importantly, clubs have also shown to have long-term benefits on the lives of people living with HIV, including improved adherence and retention in care, as they are now able to better fit the management of HIV around their home and work lives.
Clubs are a long-term retention in care strategy, and MSF believes that we need to roll these out throughout South Africa and similar models in the rest of sub-Saharan Africa to make sure that we can get all the people on treatment that we need on treatment and retain them in care. But if we roll out clubs, there is still a certain amount of resource planning required by the Department of Health. Firstly, the Department of Health still needs to invest in club facilitators to run the clubs. Secondly, the clubs at the moment do not provide a lot of relief for the pharmacy. All of these patients still need their drugs pre-packed, and we know that we have a massive burden on pharmacies already. So we can use strategies and planning to ensure that we also reduce the burden on pharmacy staff. This can be done either by simply just adding more pharmacy assistants, depending on how many clubs a facility is running, or making sure that South Africa endorses fixed dose combinations quickly, because clubs will really benefit from pre-packed FDCs, which are quick for pharmacies to pre-pack, and also much simpler for us to be able to transport to community art clubs. The Department of Health can also learn from the Western Cape, where they are now using a central dispensing unit. So the clinic pharmacies are not pre-packing for the clubs. Scripts are going to a central unit, which are pre-packing the drugs and sending them to the clinic, already packed for the clubs. Lastly, we can still make the club system even more efficient by changing it from a 2 month supply to a 3 month supply. MSF would like to see all stable, adherent ART patients who choose to do so being able to receive their treatment every 3 months around the corner from their home through a community ART club. This will allow our patients to stay on treatment for the rest of their lives.
The stigma is still there. People don't understand you. And then if you are shy, it will take you down. So the club, that's where it comes in. Those who don't want to talk about it, but who still want to go to the clinic, or those who have not yet been to the clinic to get tested, when they see someone with HIV and you talk about it to them openly, they start to say, oh, I must go get tested because I can see so-and-so is living positively and she's a happy person.